Now you listen to me real good. I've told you once, I said it 1,000 times. You get out of those pagan, satanic, religious, Christian churches. Christians do not follow the commandments of the Bible. Christians do what they want to do. They make up their own laws, their own rules, and their own regulations. Come out of her, my people, and come out from among them. And it's real simple and easy to ascertain who are these people you need to come out from. Easy. Number one, if they keep Sunday, that's an automatic sign that you need to not have any fellowship with these commandment-breaking, wicked deceivers and seducers and bewitchers of the truth. Simple. All right, now we're going to go ahead and get started today. We're going to be in the Torah, okay? We're going to give y'all some educational understanding. All right, now y'all try to listen without the Western mindset, okay? Try to listen, all right? I believe if a man choose to be celibate, he can be celibate. If a man choose to be monoligamous, he can be monoligamous, meaning one wife. If a man choose to have more than one wife, he can have more than one wife. No, I mean, that's your prerogative. Are you following me? Just make sure you're being lawful and you're doing right in every instance and every aspect. You follow me? Be responsible. You know that MGTOW guy that asked the question down there? You know, he turned around and sent me a note and said, "Pastor, I considered what you said and I've changed my perspective and views." Isn't that something? Isn't that beautiful? He keep on listening. He may be an Israelite one day to end up on it. Isn't that beautiful? See, the ideal is for you to be able to know him in the beauty of holiness. Y'all get that? But you have to have his sayings in your heart. You can't be religious. You done that enough. You already know how to be religious. All right? You have to be saints of the Most High Yah. And he equips us to being saints by giving us the Ruach. Is that right? We have the Ruach, and then he's our helper as we go along in this journey. And as we go along in this journey, we discover things about ourselves that we don't like. Sometimes we don't realize that we don't like them. We have so much a love affair with sin, iniquity, and transgression, we find ourselves protecting it at times until the knowledge of truth comes. And then, of course, it happens whenever you've been walking vain for so long, you discover that, my God, man, my eyes have been opened up. All of a sudden, what happens then? Then you start hating the garment that was spotted by the flesh. You follow me? You see, Brother Darrell, right here? I would never know that I had a problem with madness until he came around. I was doing fine until he came around. When he started coming around, I started getting these electrical shocks going through my body. When I look at him, man, my blood pressure, I could tell it's shooting up. My Fitbit says it. It was going off the chain, man. My eyes started getting red. I tried to drink water and stuff. And I said, maybe if I ignore him, then I could get through this sermon right now because my head's hurting, man. I would have never known the person that I was like that until he came around. Now, the truth is, that was something that was already in me. You following? It was just waiting for the time to show out. And it wanted me to blame him for what I was feeling. Because it wasn't in him, it was in me. He come to me and I go, "Oh boy, I make up excuse, go tune the guitar, do something." Y'all think I'm talking about Brother Darrell, don't you? That's an opportunity for you to be able to work out your salvation. Hallelujah. How many of y'all sisters listen to Mother Gina more than once? I want to see. Keep your hands up. I want to see. Now I know who's not interested in sanctification and holiness. Look at that.
And that's all. I ain't tell y'all to turn around. Look, I'm doing the judging here. You trying to take home, make sure your wife listening. Brother Mike said, I'm making sure my wife listening. And you got to ask yourself, why wouldn't you want to listen to that? Male and female alike got rebuked. We talking about next level. What are you going to do when you have a spirit that pure talking to you? Giving you nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Be you monoligamous or polygamous. It still didn't give you nowhere to run or hide. Like I said before, it's amazing. When you get somebody else saying something, all of a sudden it's, whoo, light bulb, whoo. Pastor Dow says it's, it was like a mad dog grabbing hold of a raggedy towel and shaking it back and forth. And you ain't hating me, you're hating on him. But she really gave it to you, didn't she? A wife is somebody that's 100% assimilated. See, I'm a good wife to the father. He don't have no trouble with me at all. I'm 100% assimilated with him. You'll never see me run around mad at y'all. And you know what? He don't never ask me, he never really clues me on what he's going to do next either. He just does it. And expect me to give it a program. Then all of a sudden, all those deficits, emotional deficits start showing up. All of them excuses the devil gives. Well, you ain't walked a mile in my shoes. I'm glad I didn't. Because if I did, I'd have corns and bunions and everything else, wouldn't I? Gout and everything else wouldn't have been with the pain you had been experiencing. Ain't y'all good? Y'all should actually go back and listen to anything. I saw Elder Rupert called me the other day. He said, I'm already on number 10. I said, Elder Rupert 10. He said, yeah, I'm going farther too. He said, because just when I thought I heard it, I promised I'd have missed something else. Now, we often talk about the restoration of all things, don't we? All right. What is the root word of restoration? To restore. All right. So how can you have a restoration of all things which is at hand if you can't restore? Restore the things that has been lost. Things have been taken away. See, more than anything, I keep telling y'all what they have done is the powers that be religiously and civilly, the governments of the world, they have dealt with us wisely. They have taken away economic power from our hands. They have taken away true brotherhood, true sisterhood, true family, everything. All because they have taught you how to fill your head full of the ideals of jealousy and envy which you function after. As a matter of fact, many of you serve them more than you do the Father. Isn't it amazing? Remember I told y'all a long time ago, everybody thinks that truth is readily available and that they just love it? No, you don't. No, you don't. You don't love truth like you think you do. You love the truth that you have accepted. You love the truth you have already believed. You do not love truth like you think you do. I told you. I don't know what happened with some of your conversion, but when I first repented, it was the most ugly time in my life. I mean, I didn't experience nothing but sorrow, heartache, and pain for about a solid 15, 20, 30 minutes. That's all I experienced. As I began to cry and call out every single one of my sins. Can you imagine that? Here you are in an assembly a little bit bigger than this, and you up here by yourself over here just crying out and calling every sin. And you know I'm loud. I'm very loud. And when I got finished with that, all of a sudden, next thing you know, I started praising. I didn't know what to do. I was Baptist, a hypocritical Baptist at that. I started clapping my hands and giving glory to y'all. Next thing you know, I received a baptism of the Holy Spirit, which I didn't know I was going to receive. That's how I know it's real. And that's how the apostolic church knew it was real, because nobody gave me any guidance. It must have been time. And been running for Jesus for a long time. And I'm not tired, and I'm not gonna now, because I ain't gonna be no yet. I'm in this to the end. Hallelujah. Amazed, isn't it? And so I never forgot my first love. Spend time with him every day. I don't get to spend hours on end. I spend some morning devotional time with him, and then he expect me to walk this thing out. Hallelujah. And as I go, it's revealed. As I go, understanding, comprehension, or overstanding is revealed. So here we are, Yates, 2 decades later. I'm farther along now than when I first began. Isn't that the way it's supposed to be? If you're a tree, you're going to have fruit. It's going to be ripening. Most people, they get into it, hypocritical as they are, and they pay more attention to the trials and the tribulations than the deliverer. I've been through many ups and downs. Man, Satan has squeezed me just like he squeezed anybody else, if not the more so. I told you one night I was in the house, man. I was getting ready to go to bed. And you know that you're in between that time where you're laying down and then you're half up. And all of a sudden, man, this spirit appeared. And you know what it was doing? It said that it would make me a big time preacher. All I have to do is back off the message. Just back off a little bit. So I know what they done. I know what every one of them boogers have done. You know what I did? Looked up straight up at it. I said, go to hell. I went right back to sleep. Most of you have been trying to climb the ceiling or wall or something like that. I'm sitting up there thinking, I'm tired. You're going to come in here like this. And I've only had 2 visions since. I have a vision for the ministry. You look at these little children right here. We do this thing right. Can you imagine? They wouldn't have to worry about trying to find a husband or a wife. They'd have ones that are bought up in the law, statutes, and commandments. Today, we're having a difficult time trying to find a husband or wife. Because the only pool we can pull from is the folks that's coming from the world. Because we sitting in here and been here a long time, and we still ain't holy as we should be. Still ain't as sanctified as we should be. It ain't like we don't have examples setting before us, because we do. Yes, we do too. Oh, yes, we do. Isn't that the truth? Uh-huh. Yep, we do. Yep. So we have no excuse. Whosoever you yield your members, servants to obey. Did y'all hear that? That's whose servants you are. Did you hear that? Whoever you yield yourself and members to obey. So you need to love truth. Embrace it, wear it like a glove. Hallelujah. Glory to the King. Let's go on with today's Torah message here. It's good seeing all y'all. I'm glad to see that the devil hadn't took you out of the faith yet. So I said, what do you mean yet? You know how many people I've seen come and go? I'm still here. Still here. You ever seen an old raggedy shoe before? That's Elder Doug. He's still here. He's just still here. Just an old shoe. That's what we call old people, old shoe. But they still here. You seen it on the road 5 years ago, and it's still sitting there. It come back and still be here. You know why? Because there ain't nothing else for us to do. Nothing else for us to do. I got back here, I wanted to get on the roof and just up, and had so many things impairing me to do that. But Elder Doug and Brother Scott and Brother Brent took off, went to South Carolina, and was helping them build that community down there. How many other people you know that would sacrifice their time, energy, and effort to go and work their fingers to the bone for somebody else, and they're not going to live there? Can you imagine the type of rewards that's being sent up? Hmm? Can you imagine that? See, what it is people are so selfish, self-centered, self-focused, self-absorbed. And they're afraid to do something for somebody because they're always looking for. Afraid of it. Just literally afraid of it. And can't get pleasure out of doing for your brothers and sisters who you say you love. Hmm? Isn't that amazing? It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. What's being developed? 5 years, you're not even going to know the ministry. Somebody said, yeah, I ain't going to know it because I ain't going to be here. Man, that's bad, isn't it? Where are you going to go? Back to sin? Back to the world? Back to religion? You're going to put makeup on, it's going to make you happy? People come, the first thing one of them sisters do when they leave here, they take that head covering and throw that thing as far as they can. I asked them, all of them, I said, man, you read the newsletter? Wow. I ought to start carrying me some milk bone dog biscuits in my pocket. Because you just never know what people are going to fire off on you, boy. They just going to go off on you, man. At least anything I want, the milk bone dog biscuits keep that tart off your teeth, and then I get to see some white teeth in them. In other words, that was a funny. We ain't got started. Spirit's jacked up already. Lord to the King. Brother Steve said, look, this is me. Biblical marriage. Me waiting for anybody to show me a law saying more than one wife is a sin. Brother Steve is something else, ain't he? That brother got that mind. He is something else, isn't he? Glory to the King. This goddess woman worship today has made men gone crazy. I mean crazy. Rome is America and America is Rome. Did y'all hear me, Israel? Don't you mistake that. We are still in Rome. All you have to do is pay attention to the architect, pay attention to the society and what it does. If you read the history books, you'll know that we're following to a T. The decline of ancient Rome. To a T we are. Now look what we got. The White House couldn't wait for the Supreme Court to do a clean sweep. Look at that. They turn around and make a mockery out of the bow, and they paint the White House the color of the bow. Couldn't wait for it. That means they already had that in place prior to the decision coming down. Somebody's in cahoots. We're going to return and keep on returning. Hallelujah. Now, 1 Timothy 4:1 says, now the what? The Spirit speaking expressly in the what time? Now, mind you, this was written how many years ago? Just about 2,000 years ago, right? Give or take some years, right? In the latter times. All right? That some are going to do what? That's the only reason why people depart. See, because to be in the faith, you have to be around Israelites. Nobody's an island to themselves. Even then, they were going from house to house, hiding. You'll read in the Renewed Covenant, the church which is at Ephesus, the church which is at Philippi, the church which is at Rome, and all these different assemblies. Church at Galatia. You follow me? They will go into houses and have fellowships. And today they create these big old churches and stuff. You feel like that you're doing something when you go to church that you really don't have true fellowship. Because we don't want that personal interaction. Isn't that right? But it says that some are going to depart from the faith and they're going to give heed to what kind of spirits? Spirits that will seduce you from the way. And doctrines or teachings of devils. Hmm? Look what else the Spirit does. The Spirit is going to forbid men to marry. But watch this. It doesn't forbid forbidden marriage. Does not the law say mankind should not lie with mankind as with woman and all that do so is an abomination? Did not Paul say in Romans the first chapter, even their women left the natural use of the woman and burned in their lust one towards another? Did he not say that? And I say that. See, they're covering all bases. So, well, it ain't written in the Torah, but yeah, it is. If Paul is giving you the, if he's giving you that, he's letting you know what the comprehension of the Torah is. Y'all follow it? It's just a beautiful thing. So, patriarch, man rules. You see, I like this picture right here. I really, truly do. I really, truly have never liked fighting. Are you following me? But I never did run away from one, if you know what I mean. Are you following me? I never ran away from one. And if we're going to fight, we're going to fight. You understand what I mean? And I guess that's just a man in any man. You follow me? That's a man. You know what I mean? But while I was there, I enjoyed it. Because it was kind of like a competition, if you know what I mean. I mean, it's kind of crazy, but people in them days, they were dying. And many of them weren't even dying for their cause. They was dying for another cause. We're in a cause where we should be dying every day to ourselves for Christ in order to live for him. And yet, we don't even have the honor to even fight the devil that is constantly resisting us from the faith. Isn't that true? Yes, sir. So for honor's sake, we're at war. Now, Exodus 5:2 says, look at this. Yahweh is my what? Can somebody cut these fans off right here? Yahweh is my strength. And notice, the woman is not my strength. She ain't my champion either. Y'all hear this? Yahweh is my strength. Male or female, Yahweh is your strength. Y'all get that? Not no woman, not no man. Yahweh is your strength. Hallelujah. And he is my song. My strength and song, and he has become my salvation. He is my Yah, and I will prepare him a habitation, my father Yah, and I will exalt him. Y'all see the reason why I got over this woman worship? See, that's seducing spirits. There's something seduced you to get your mind away from. And that's what happened when you reprobate. See, what y'all actually saw was a display of a reprobate mind. I told y'all that down there. This is clearly a reprobate mind. And you can't get any more extreme than that. And you should take heed to your own selves. You really should. Proverbs 31:3 says, give not thy strength unto who? Women, nor thy ways to that which destroyeth kings. You hear that? In other words, why should you go out here and be an army and go fight somebody 5,000 miles away just because King Obama said so? Psalms 29:11, Yahweh will give strength unto who? His people. Yahweh will bless his people with what? With peace. Now, we have to get this in our heart and our mind. Our father came from here and ended up here. The new Jerusalem is going to compass this landmass of here. It's just not going to be this little piece of land that this war and torn place that everybody fighting over, okay? It don't come down. So our mind, our thinking, and our comprehension needs to return to this perspective. Y'all get that? And he's returned to this perspective rather than this perspective, which ended up over here. See, you look like Israelites on the outside, but on the inside, you're still Gentiles in mind in the way that you think and the way that you function. Because if you knew what I knew, I promise you'd be running as fast as you can towards Yah. And you wouldn't let nothing hinder you. Hallelujah. Now, marriage. One man, one woman. A man's brother, widow in the Levirate law. Y'all remember that, the Levirate law? Alright. Also, a man has a wife. I don't know why they dressed a concubine like that, but who knows. Alright. Also, but we had laws for rapists. If you raped a woman and stuff, she became your wife. Y'all see that? A man and woman, as far as the property goes. In other words, this is a servant. When people indenture themselves. All right? a war bride. Man went to war, saw a damsel there. He made her real ugly before he decided to go into her. Shaved her head, pair of nails, and then after 30 days of mourning, notice there's laws. Speaks nothing about the status of the man. And just because I'm talking like this, that doesn't mean that your man want another wife. He may want another wife. I don't know why he would want another American wife. I don't know why an American woman would want another one of these American men either. We're going to tell the truth both sides, all right? All right, so a man, he could have as many wives as he want. The law was against foreign wives that will serve other gods. Then you had the male and female slave servant, which the master would end up giving the indentured servant who was indentured to him for 6 years, a woman, to become his wife. All right? Y'all get this, right? Now, the reason why we talk about this, because remember I talked about that big old elephant in the room? It's been there for a long time, but everybody's afraid to talk about it. And y'all know me, I'm not afraid to talk about anything that's controversial. You know what I mean? Because to me, if the truth is pressed down, if it's hidden, that means there's a greater truth that is being kept from us. There's a greater deliverance. There's something else working besides this surface emotions and feelings that we're going through. I'm telling you, that's why I dig hard. I'm well past this. I want the next one to come. I'm waiting for the next one to come because as soon as it comes, I'm going to hit it hard too. Truth sets free. Lie always binds. Always does. Now, Jacob's family, you know, he's the patriarch that had his name changed to Israel, right? He had Leah and he had Rachel and the two servants. And then out of which comes all the tribes of Israel. Is that right? The law which regulates polygyny and is accepted, Moses is the one who wrote the law for it. Case law number one, a servant woman given to a Hebrew man. Have y'all not wondered, since most of you have been in messianic groups and stuff and you've been Torah observing for a while, why is it that all this is in the Torah but nobody ever has ever talked about it? I guess the same way the reason why Christians don't talk about the Sabbath. Then they conveniently ignore it because it was something they're not interested in. They wanted to have a form of godliness, but denied the power. Are you following me? So let's go on this and get some understanding. When we read over in Exodus 21, you're dealing with four different case laws. You're not dealing with a consecutive happening. Are you following me? And mind you, even with all this, you need to be viewing this in light of yourself with your relationship with the Father. Just don't only look at it's just husband and wife. You need to pay attention to your relationship to the Father. Are you following me? Was not we a servant to sin at one time? Did we not serve sin in our own lust and divers lust? Did we not do that? God, the master would be the Father. Isn't that right? Isn't that right? And he actually paid a price for us. Did he not pay a price for us? Yes, he did too. And in that's the reason why I tell you, marriage is very important to comprehend and understand according to what the scriptures say. Because when this is all said and done, we're all going to get married. We're all betrothed right now. And we're going to even learn in this, that if you don't get designated as a wife, that this master can put you away. We're going to learn in this passage right here. So you see, we have the natural thing that deals with marriage, but then we also have our relationship with the Father. And if you don't comprehend your role, be you male or female, all right, gender neutral in this, because we're all married to the Father right now. We're betrothed to him. We're not to go out here and serve and commit adultery with devils and other gods. Is that right? We exclusively belong to him and him alone. He has already given us laws, statutes, and commandments, and he didn't ask us if we agreed with him or not. He just told us, this is my covenant, and this is what you're going to do, and we pledge exclusive monoligamy to him. Meaning, we only going to love him and serve him, and that is it. Is that right? Now you see the reason why he's a jealous Elohim? The reason why he wants you to go around here joining all these other gods and all these other churches that act like that they serving the same God, but the truth is they're not. Which Paul warned us that there will be people coming to preach you another Yahshua, another Jesus. I didn't preach him. That's what he said. Now, don't go kill them and murder them, but bear with them. All right, but you just know that there's another deity that's being preached, not the one that I've been preaching, not the one that I've been serving. Y'all get that? All right, so let's look at this from both natural and spiritual. Now, these are the judgments which thou shalt set before them. If you buy a Hebrew servant, or what kind of servant? A Hebrew servant, 6 years he shall serve. And in the seventh, he shall go out free for what? Why? Because he ended up paying his debt by being in servitude to you. And you know what's amazing to me? The Bible says that the borrower is servant to the lender, right? We don't mind freely indenturing ourselves to the system. And we don't get to go out in the 7 year. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yeah, we're going to touch it. Yeah, see, you don't mind going involuntary being a slave to this system. Look at you. What, the cat got your tongue? Look at you. As soon as we start talking about something spiritual, oh. At least Yah's merciful. He gives you a time limit to give you your life back. This system ain't giving you nothing back. If anything, they have figured out ways to indenture you even more. Anybody listening to me? Now, do you listen to me? Come here, Nadia. Look at my beautiful granddaughter right here. Look at her. Isn't she beautiful? Well, you done snuck a couple of inches in on me too, ain't you? Man, Freeman, what's she going to be this tall, man? Isn't she beautiful? You love granddaddy? See, between me and her father, we have to make sure that she gets a good husband. Ain't no bootlicker gonna get her and mess her up. Like some of you been messed up. And still messed up today. We're gonna preserve her. Uh-oh, boy. Isn't that beautiful? You're going to get married one day, ain't you? You ain't thinking about it right now, though, are you? No, no, no. Isn't that good? That's beautiful, isn't it? You eating Wheaties with steroids or something? You getting tall. You getting tall. But see, this is the hope that for all our daughters of Zion. Because if you don't be careful and raise them in the law, statutes, and commandments. And teach them the fear of Yah. And a mother, where you at, mother? Wait, mother, you teach her to honor her father, to reverence him and love him. She needs to learn how to honor and respect her father now so she'll know how to reverence and honor her husband later. Don't you dare sit up there and get mad at Freeman and then throw your little spirit off and everything and they see you turning your little tetris. Because that's communication. Because they're going to think that behavior is the way that you ought to behave whenever you get upset. A wise woman build a house, but a foolish woman pluck it down with her hands. They don't need to see any irritability whatsoever. All they need to see is nothing but love for the Father. Then when she gets married, her husband will perceive that her merchandise is good and he will guard her even the more so. See, that's the type of holy nation that we need. You follow me? That's what we're trying to produce here. Glory to the King. All right, bless you, honey. Now, you know what's happening, right? There's some brothers out there on the other side of that camera. That's all you can do is scope. Oh, hallelujah. But we got the comprehension of this, right? If he came in by himself, he shall do what? That means if he came in with no family members, he should go out. If he were married, all right? Then his wife shall go out what? With him. All right? You see this case law, first one, right? If his master have given him a wife, if the master did what? Why? Because a man has needs. A woman has needs. No one sit up and have his man 6-7 years and stuff, and here he is, he doesn't have a companionship, a wife or a woman. This master's pretty good, isn't it? He gives him a wife. All right? Torah law, though, instructions, right? Look what instruction says. And she have borne him sons and what? Well, chances are, wife meaning designation, you're going to get married, that means you're going to have sex, right? So you're going to have children. They're coming sooner or later, right? And it says, if you have born the sons and daughters, look what the instructions say. The wife and her children shall be her what? Why? Because that is his property. Just like we are Yah's property. Whether you like it or not, you're bought and paid for. That's another thing we don't understand is the price that's been paid for us. We keep forgetting. What we need to do is we need to remind ourselves of the sacrifice it took just to get one of us. Everybody think he did it for the nation, but he was thinking about every individual in that nation. Uh-huh. You better believe it. Oh, every time I think about it, I fall in love all over again. Mm-hmm. Take a worm like me from the world. Cleanse me up. Clean me up. Huh? It's just a beautiful thing. Especially when you comprehend and get it. Just a beautiful thing. Mm-hmm. So the children and her still belongs to the master. And he shall go out by himself. See, he has an option. He can either choose to go on with his own little selfish life, or he can be responsible. He can choose to go on with his own little pathetic, selfish life, or he can be responsible. We're going to find out if he really, truly loved his wife and children. When a man finds a wife, he finds a... Well, this one was given. When a man finds a wife, he finds a... And attains favor with who? So guess what? That master, he found favor with the master, and the master gave him a... Don't get all spiritual with me. All right, look at this. So we're going to see if this is about him or is it about what he says he loves. All right? And if the servant shall plainly say, I love my what? First and foremost, you see, men, you. That's why I stay on us so hard. You've got to have a love affair and a perfect relationship with the master. Don't be expecting all this out of everybody else and you're not producing it yourself. The only fear of Yah that your family is going to ever learn is what they see in you. That's it. So notice, he said, I love my master and I love my what? Wife and my children. He says, I'm not going to go free. This is not a selfish man. This is a man of responsibility. Duty and responsibility. Y'all hear me? This is not a selfish man at all. All right. Then his master shall bring him unto the what? The judges. You see, the judges are is Elohim's. Check that out. The Elohim's. The judges is the ones who are the magistrates, the rulers. In our day, it would be the pastors and the elders. But we don't want to go to the pastors and the elders. Y'all heard me hang up on a brother last night. Y'all hear me hang up on a brother last night. Didn't I tell y'all this thing is getting ready to get straight and even more narrow? And y'all don't seem, y'all notice, I'm not toying around. I ain't playing at all. These brothers go out here and just do whatever they want to do and expect us to just open up our arms and say, you know, Pastor, love me in my sin. No, you're going to go do that over at the Christian church. You ain't doing that here. Sad part about it is, you have so many sisters that are just so beaten down emotionally that they'll take any snake crawling around. Have no honor for themselves whatsoever at all. It's disgusting. I mean, don't y'all expect a higher standard out of us? Oh, y'all don't? Oh, you do? Which one is it? I ain't hearing too much of nothing. But anyway, take him to the magistrate, the rulers, and the judges. Go back. He shall also bring him to the door and unto the doorpost, and his master shall bore his ear through with the what? We ain't got to worry about that. People go pay to get their ears bored through today. You know, I got a newsletter on earrings. All it is just showing you how much of a slave you are to this world. You didn't get it from a master in Israel. Now, just say something wrong. See, we indenture ourselves in so many ways that we don't even comprehend. I can run that Bible from Genesis all the way through about earrings. We don't want to hear that pastor now. Nothing is going to make you more beautiful than a meek and quiet spirit. You ain't see nothing? Meek and quiet spirit? See, Philistines? See, they coming up with a meek and quiet spirit. Mm-hmm. And both of them been rebuked and reproved too. By sisters on this land. Mm-mm-mm. And shall serve him for how long? So you mean to tell me that now we're supposed to be serving the Father forever? See, it's this Roman Empire with their Christian religion that's made you think you can go out, you can come in. You can go out, you can come in. You can go out, you can come in. And think that y'all's going to sit there and toy around to a schizophrenic mindset. One minute you in the kingdom, next minute you out of the kingdom. One minute you in the kingdom, next minute you out of the kingdom. Yeah, do that one more time too often. I sit and watch people who is in it, seem like they were 100% for, and then they entertained the thought and got out. All they makes me do is fear. I'm like, man, you mean to tell me it was that easy to turn back? Whoo. Y'all listen. We go on. Case law number two, contracted and not designation. All right. Exodus 21:7, and if a man sell his daughter to be a what? What kind of servant is she? All right. She shall not go out as the what servants? And what do women try to do today? Act like men. Isn't that right? Don't women think you got the rights because America tell you so. And they made monsters out of you. They got you thinking like men. They got men thinking like women. You better pay attention to the book. I love the Bible. You love the scriptures? A maidservant is a female slave, made, handmaid, or a concubine. All right? And look, if she please not her what? So if this woman does not please her master, who have betrothed her to himself. Notice the word betrothed. All right? Betrothed her to himself. Then shall he let her be what? Redeemed to sell her unto a strange nation. He has no power. In other words, you cannot take this servant and give her over to another nation. You follow me? Can't do that, kind of like Joseph got sold to the Midianites. All right? Or put in the hands of Midianites. Look at this. Seeing he have dealt with her, how did he deal with her? Deceitfully. Now, please not her what? Master. Those who want to deal with the Hebrew 74:51 and the Hebrew 58:69. The first one is bad. She doesn't please. Displeased and great grief. The second one is the outward appearance or countenance is displeasing to the eye. In other words, this man has done bought this woman, betrothed a servant and slave, and then he turns around, are you following me? And then the man brings her to him, and he looks at her and he goes, oh my God, this is one ugly woman. Now I know that may be a hard for y'all, but it's just the truth. She is not pleasing to the eye. That's what the Hebrew is saying. All right? Sorry, she don't look like Morgan Fairchild. And don't ask me who that is. I just saw it on the YouTube commercial. The name sounds good. I don't know, man. Exodus 21:8. And if he please not a master who have betrothed her to himself, then he shall let her be redeemed and to sell her unto a strange nation. He shall have no power, seeing he have dealt with her deceitfully, betrothed. Agreement, appointment, assign, or designate. All right? Look at this. And she pleased. I keep going over again. Not her master. She's not a well-pleasing woman to the eye. Has nothing to do with servitude or nothing. She just doesn't look good. Period. She shall be redeemed, and to sell her, redeem, to release, preserve, recuse, to be ransomed. Look at this. To sell her unto a what kind of nation? Strange nation. You can't do it. You cannot do it. Seeing he have dealt with her deceitfully. Deceitfully means bad, treacherously, faithless, deceitful, or offended. I mean, if a woman's not, if she's ugly, she don't like being told she's ugly. I'm sorry, Brother Darrell. To me, you ugly. Not only you ugly, you ugly as hell. And all you men are ugly. Ain't no man ever looked good to me. You all ugly. Well, you too, Pastor. Good. I'm glad we all agree. I ain't got to worry about no faggot homosexual tendencies on your D&D, do it. We make sure we step out of no entertainment at all. Oh, hallelujah. Bother me none. I don't mind being ugly. Somebody got to be ugly. Everybody can't look good. Everybody, look at Ariel, man. That's a nice looking young man. Everybody can't look like him. Huh? Somebody got to be ugly. I guess I fill in the gap. Bring up the hedge. Fill in the breach. Cross the Rubicon. Case law number 3. Daughter-in-law. And if he have betrothed her unto his what? Isn't that just like a wonderful dad? You got an ugly woman that you done betrothed and you gonna give her to your son. Boy, don't you just love your son? Come on. Ain't nothing like a father's love, is it? That's letting you know how much say-so the son had. That's a mess, isn't it? That make you want to pull one of them last of Mohicans and go jump off the side of a mountain on it. But we got to keep Torah. Hallelujah. Keep instructions. Look at this. And if you have bought trouble to her son, he shall deal with her after the manner of what then? Daughters. In other words, now she has become his daughter-in-law. You get it? Son couldn't say that. Uh-oh, dad. Shut up, boy. Don't worry about you young men straight. Well, I'm going to hook you up. Y'all want a wife so bad, we're going to hook you up. We're going to go up here to this cone up here where these people don't take baths but twice a year. Oh, hallelujah. This is proof that this man was already married. Because where did the son come from? So you got to get them nuggets in there. Most people say, I ain't married. But where did he get the son from? Ah, it's in there, isn't it? Case law number 4. The master did not take her. And if he take him another wife, her food, her raiment, and her duty of marriage, shall he not what? So he's already married to this one. If he takes another one, you cannot diminish at all. And that diminish means you know, you cut a plate of food, you cut a wardrobe from clothing, and you trim down the sexual rights. That diminish means you don't move her from a wife status to a servant status. Y'all get that? You don't move her from a wife status to a servant status. You get it? So, verse 7, recapping, a woman is bought to be a wife. Verse 8, he turns around, he rejects her from being a wife, and he gives her to his son. Yeah, nice. What is this old, fat, greasy, ugly-looking woman with scabs all on her face? You need another servant for your wife to come and help around the land, and all of a sudden you go, woo-wee! This woman, toe-down, ugly, boy. John, come here, John. Look at John. John, Son, your dad got a nice wife for you. The big broad shoulders, boy, Johnny, he about to faint. Would you love your dad for that? Say yes! Say yes!
Yes, sir.
Say, all right, bless you, Johnny. See, you got a good son. All right, so he contracted her to be his wife. The only thing left was him to consummate the marriage, which at that time he never did. All right? To be blunt, the man decided not to marry her because the woman was just too ugly. So, like a good father, he gives his ugly woman to his son. At least he didn't give her a stone. You know what I mean? Gave a piece of bread to give you a stone. Didn't give you a serpent for a fish. See, y'all don't never see the bright side in everything, do you? You gotta look, you gotta find the good in everything. Y'all something else. Y'all know y'all something else, don't you? Verse 9, he contracts her for a wife, for his son, and he must treat her as a what? You have to treat her as a daughter. A different case law is in the fact that in verse 10, Exodus 21:10, if he takes him another wife or food or raiment, and her duty of marriage should not be diminished. Verse 10, he did not fulfill his obligation, then took another woman for a wife. I mean, he did. Don't put not in there. I'll be reading too fast. He did fulfill his obligation, and he took a woman for the wife. All right? Later on in the text, it tells us that a man takes a wife and then gives the law concerning treatment of this wife. He shall not what? Diminish her food or clothing or sexual rights. You don't take a wife and then treat her as a servant, because a servant is not entitled to none of that. Meat for bread. Raiment for rags. Servant don't get conjugal rights, marital rights. Only the concubines and the status of a wife. To diminish any of these would to put her back in the status of a servant. So following the narrative, these are independent conditions in the text. Now, in Isaiah 4:1, and it says, in that day, how many women? Now we like quoting this isolated. We don't get the understanding of this one, so we don't quote it isolated. We get confused by chapters and verses. Are you following me? And then it prevents us from reading it in context. All right, so look what it says. Seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own what? Sound like an American woman. We'll wear our own apparel. Only let us be what? Called by our name to take away our reproach. Now, what kind of conditions was up on the earth for the women to actually come and state this to this man? Seven of them got together. All right, one man. Bread, apparel, name, and they want the reproach taken away, right? The description of these women are written about in chapter 3. As for my people, you ever heard that? Look, that's you, his people. As for my people. So don't think about the world. When we read this, you think about you, Israel. You, Israel. Yah said, as for my people. All right? Look what he says. Children are there what? Oppressors, and women do what? That's why I keep telling y'all men, don't you give your strength to a woman. Children oppressing, women rule. Tell me that's not taking place today. That's not speaking negative or derogatory. We're talking about proper order. That's what we're talking about. Proper order and perspective, because when you do respond the way that the order is, that's when you find not only peace and happiness, but the spiritual protection that you've always been looking for. When you go contrary to that, you're going to experience all the oppression of the enemy. You get it? Look at this. Oh, my people, they which what? Lead thee, cause thee to what? In other words, the people who are leading you, who are allowing the children to oppress them, and the women to rule over them, they are the ones by their example are causing you to err. You get it? And destroy the way of thy paths. You know, we got to stay on this path and stuff. And if you got the wrong people sitting out in front of you, they're going to have you compromised. They, you know, you're going to be off the path in a little while. Hallelujah. Yes, the IU 3:16 come from the scripture verse. And Yahweh says, because the daughters of Zion are what? Because the daughters of Zion are what? And they walk out with stretched forth necks and seductive eyes, walking and mincing as they go, making a jingling with their feet. That used to be some of you. Didn't it? See, all the men today think that the grass is green on the other side. You go out there and you look at all these women in Hollywood, everybody bouncing and gyrating and everything else, and these people out there in the streets, and they put this makeup on. Can you imagine waking up to that every morning? Or better yet, hold on. Therefore, Yahweh shall smite with the what? Somebody say a word. The crown of your head. Is that right? Of the daughters of Zion. So he's smiting the men. He's smiting the who? The women of daughters of Zion. And Yahweh shall expose their what? Can you imagine waking up to them moon craters every morning? Woman got scabs all over her face. You don't know what that makeup is covering up. But see, all you see is this. And you ain't, what can you imagine that? And you ain't never seen her like this. Come on. After the flesh, don't they look like a beautiful woman? See, when you get a real true daughter of Zion, you ain't got to worry about all this. Because you get to see them for what they are. You, ooh, look at that. MTV, ooh, YouTube, ooh. Midnight at the Apollo, ooh. Beyonce, ooh. Mickey Nadage, ooh. Britney Spears, ooh. You dumb dumbs. And look at that thing. That's that woman that Brother Chris got scabs. Didn't it say scab? The crown of your head, look. I'm telling y'all, first of all, you don't need to be messing around with no woman wearing makeup. But if Warren did convert and they still got a trouble with makeup, you tell them, take that damn makeup off. You don't want to wake up to a scab. Look. See them faces? I mean, you look, if y'all turn around and look at our sisters, see how clear their complexion is? Y'all don't see it? How they, all of them, young and old, radiant growth. This is the world right here. And they purposely put that pig stuff in the makeup, unclean stuff, chemicals and stuff to make your skin look worse so you have to pack on more. But see, because the daughters of Zion are haughty, this is a condition that they learn. They learn to be haughty. They learn that they can go to work and have their own bread. They can buy their own apparel, but they still need a man. And the conditions have gotten so bad that seven of them will get together and just say, we'll take this one. He's scabs. Just like the prophecy says. Tears, are you all right? Where you at, Tears? I mean, the last time I saw this stuff, tears ago, pastor. Those women were horrible. It's God, please. Look at them. But see, the world, they only got you looking at this. Because she got her face on. Look at that. That's Captain Black, isn't it? Y'all see the deception of this stuff? Yeah, I want to bring an impact. Because you know what happened to men and stuff. They think they can go out and convert a Gentile. When you already got holy dolls of Zion living set apart. The Bible says that beauty is vain, but a woman in fear of Yah is greatly to be praised. Just when y'all think y'all getting a glamour girl, you getting one all right. You show her. And in that day, Yahweh takes away the finery of the anklets and the headbands and the crescents. Look, you're going to take all that best way and all's going to be left of that. Like a mugshot for prison. See, the devil got something for you. The pendants, the bracelets, and the veils, the headdresses, and the leg ornaments, and the sashes, and the perfumes, the bottles, and the amulets. That's one that voluntarily put a nose jewel in her. Got a hole right there. To, look at that, man. That's a scared of fire, doesn't it? And they haughty too, ain't they? Ain't they haughty? They put that stuff on, boy. They think they look good, don't they? The rings and the nose jewels, the costly robes and the cloaks and the shawls and the purses. The mirrors and the fine linens, the turbans and the large veils. And it shall be, look what Yah says these days, instead of a sweet fragrance, a smell of decay. And instead of a belt, a rope. And instead of well-set hair, baldness. And instead of a festival robe, a girdling, a sackcloth, and a branding instead of loveliness. Your men shall fall by the sword. Time of war. And your strength in battle. And her gate shall lament and mourn, and she deserted shall sit on the ground. There's going to be so many deaths of men. And in that day, seven women shall take a hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own food and wear our own clothes. Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. And in that day, the branch of Yahweh shall be what? Splendid and esteemed. Because before a woman like that is going to come with a holy man, you're going to be cleaned up. But he just ain't going to accept you the way you are. And the fruit of the earth shall be excellent and coming for the escaped ones of Israel. For the which ones of Israel? Y'all want y'all to look like that. Present y'all in pure holiness. That's what he coming back for. Hallelujah. And out of this remnant of Yahweh shall be called, Joel 2:32 says, and it shall come to pass, you can chain this to Isaiah, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call upon the name of Yahweh shall be what? For in Mount Zion in Jerusalem shall be deliverance as Yahweh have said, and in the remnant whom Yahweh shall call. Obadiah says, but upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance. And there shall be holiness. And the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. It's coming. The earth and the fullness thereof is the Most High, but he's going to give it to us. Jerusalem is just around the corner, Israel. It ain't that far off. I promise you it ain't. Glory to the King is not that far off at all. So, more than anything, I hope that you've learned something from the case law right here. Number one, of how really serious it is, even though at times I try to make it comical. You understand me? But make no mistake, we're very serious about this. Yah is. He speaks to us about marriage so we can be able to see what this union and covenant is all about. It's not a plaything. It's something very serious. Y'all get it? The Most High wants the men in order, and he wants his daughters of Zion in order. Hallelujah. Remember I discussed over the radio broadcast, can you imagine? Let's just use Kentucky, Tennessee, Georgia, South Carolina, Texas, just examples right now, all right? Let's say if we had communities and there's 50 people over here, 100 people over here, 70 people over here, another 50 over here. And we're having sons and daughters, and they're all being homeschooled. They're all being reared and raised in the glory of Yah. We come together for the feast days. Could not the fathers make an agreement? Well, I want to pick. You don't know how to pick. You don't know how to pick. Your fathers know how to pick real good. They know a bootlicker when they see one. You know why? Because they were a bootlicker. They know a jackleg when they see one. But they were a jackleg. Oh, yeah. And see, this is what Satan has been after the whole entire time. Because right now, the whole world, including the churches, is nothing but a cesspool of hell for servants of wickedness. All these people out here being birthed as children of hell. And what Satan wants to do is make sure that there is no holy gene pool coming from nothing. Nothing but wickedness is being born in the earth. But when we keep ourselves among ourselves, and our children are raised, and then they'll end up marrying from one tribe to the next and stuff, we got a holy nation. We got a what? A holy nation. You see it? Then we'll have the seed of righteousness on the earth. That's why everybody's fighting against this, because they're servants of sin. They're servants of the devil themselves, and they're so ignorant they can't even see the forest for the trees. They can't even comprehend what's going on. And then after our days has expired, and y'all have done planted me, hopefully we have a whole nation of righteous, holy people that can continue to keep on building and adding to the lands and continue to keep going because we give them wisdom. And then they can teach their children the laws, the statutes, and commandments and rehearse the accounts of Moses over and over and over again. Drill it into them. I don't see nothing wrong with it. So why are you fighting so hard? Why are you resisting with your ignorant self? Twenty years is not a long time at all. 20 years, these little children that are sitting in these chairs next to you will be grown. That's another whole generation. My generation has failed immensely. Greatly. Big time. And Yah is just barely raising up a few holy men in this generation to remind us, kind of like Ezra did in his day, when he read the law to them from morning to evening. And the people begin to lament because they realize how far they've been taken away from the truthfulness of the law. We hear the law so much, our heart don't even get smitten today. Where's the yearning and the longing and the desire to return? Where's the yearning and the longing and desire to restore that which has been lost? Who's the repairer of the breach and the restorer of the paths? And we're sitting up here with these ignorant emotions, these sorry feelings, while our whole nation is being decimated because the Gentiles have dealt with us wisely. Nothing but straight up warfare. Economic warfare, a spiritual warfare, all because our mind is still too far off into this world. Because you know every one of these, Tennessee, Kentucky, South Carolina, Texas, Georgia, you know every one of these, if you're going to be on these places and be in fellowship with them, these children are going to be raised in the law, statutes, and commandments. But don't think because we're in this community that the world is don't pull and tug. You know what's amazing? I said it last night. They got Amish Mennonites scattered all over the place. These boogers, number one, ain't got a drop of Ruach. They ain't got a drop of the Holy Spirit. And yet, they never go out and evangelize. They never go out and evangelize. And for hundreds of years, they've been existing. And continue to keep growing, staying amongst themselves, and we want to be like the Gentiles. Utterly amazing. And we're not prehistoric in living conditions like they are. We're just trying to get you to live set apart so you can truly be free. We're buying lands all over the place. We're building all over the place. Regardless, it's going to be done with or without you. Y'all's going to have a remnant. He already has it. And y'all know them that are his. That's why he's giving us the vision. That's why he opens our understanding. And that's one thing I love about, I love about what Yah's done with Roberts. He made sure that his seed line would be terminated in this earth. That there would be nothing coming behind him. Because if it did, with that mindset, that child would be a two more fold child of hell than he himself. And Yah at least got rid of that blasphemous, wicked, sorry, evil, demonic spirit. Go terminate that one off the earth. That is a beautiful thing, and I love it. Well, Pastor Dow, that's tough talk. Call for it too, don't it? Y'all beginning to see this? We have sisters that can homeschool. We have sisters that are intelligent enough. Look at Mother Bullock. She works with her hands. And not only do we keep her busy, but the world even comes to her. She sold choir robes for churches and all kinds of stuff out there. But people are always looking for her and her twin sister services. She never has to worry about money since her husband has passed. She's outfitting almost all of Israel. Got so much work on, she said, okay, Pastor, that's enough for right now. And I don't put no more on her until she gets caught up. And she's 62 years old. And we always wonder, where the money going to come from? If you're a woman, you shouldn't even be worried about it anyway. You're a wife, you shouldn't be worried about it. That burden is on your husband. Mother Gina is a doctor. She said, I don't have nobody looking on my shoulder all day long because I wouldn't have a job where a man is directly over me. That's kind of like our business. We could send some of you intelligent sisters, because our brothers and all our brothers, we dumb as hell. We could send some of you intelligent sisters, we could send you to dental school. We could build a building for you to be a dentist. You could be a dentist and have sisters there for a staff. Oh, I know exactly what to do. Just ain't got enough people together in the vision. Everybody too busy doing their own thing. See, the preachers out there, they want you to give, give, give. Give it in Jesus' name. Pass the offering plate and the tithe plate up so they can have a Lamborghini. The biggest Mercedes on the market. Creflo Dollar won a $60 million jet. Pass the plate. And I'm talking about getting money to buy more lands, to build more homes, to educate sisters and to give them businesses. You could have the dentistry at the top and a daycare at the bottom. And then on each community, you could have different sisters allocated for schooling. Well, I ain't going to take care of her child. What? You mean his child? That's the problem right there. Your child. You don't own no child. You don't have no child. That's the problem. See, the state taught you whenever you cut a fool and stuff, you go run to your authority and you go get your child, don't you? Well, hey, Ezra and them took about, took care of that too. Send back them wives and their children. We'll start all over. Oh, come on, Pastor Doc. Lay it to the line. And you mean to tell me after hearing all this, you're not upset? You don't feel grieved and had? Well, we got a lot of selfishness to dial to, don't we? Well, if we could have a collective mindset, you know what we could do? Oh, don't worry, the powers that be, they terrified of stuff like this. They can't stand it. What happened during the days of Egypt? They came in 70. 70. Bro, Shane, you back there? Are you back there? Get Bob McBob, the third chapter. And let's read about the 22,273. Then we're going to end on this, all right? We're going to end on this. Are y'all listening? I am an instruction teacher, meaning a Torah teacher. Yeah, straight up. I know the law. Yes, I do. I know the law greater now than what I did 10 years ago. And I know what the system has done to gain us, to keep us cursed too. Keep the blessings away from us. I think it starts at verse, 43?
Where you at, Pastor, again?
Bamikbar, the third chapter. Y'all doing okay? We don't want to wear out the patience of the saints. Huh? Meditating on that vision, huh? I'm telling you. Why y'all think we work so hard around here? I mean, we were showing y'all how to work, and we getting old. I got this thing set up so all the lands that involve a straightway will be put into a trust. So it won't be no one dictator rising up. So I can trust me. And y'all can trust me. I don't know about the person coming behind me until they get proven. Oh. See, I know I'm going to do right. Uh-oh. I see some of the selfish ambition that's in the light, in the eyes of some of you. Just because I don't say nothing, don't think I'm all together just like you. I be letting the cat out of the bag all the time. I'm seriously concerned about our children. Seriously concerned about them. This world has done past gone from bad to worse. It's gone from bad to hell now. To a literal hell. Unbelievable what's going on out there. We up there, Brother Shane, we are sitting up here in a restaurant. Myself, Brother Shane, Elder Rufus, and Brother Jermaine. And this thing that came over to wait on us, it looked like a man, but it was pregnant like a woman. I'm telling you, even talk like a man. But it looked pregnant like a... Bro, saying, can you confirm? Can you second that motion?
Yes, sir.
Even that, you know how they wear the pants down like this and stuff, and you look at it, and you're looking at it, and we're up here trying to figure out, is that a man? That's just like a man. It's got an Adam's apple too, man. But then what is that? And you want your children to be immersed with that kind of stuff. That's what you want. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For all that is in the world is the lust of the eye and the lust of the flesh and the pride of life. And you love it. And I can't stand it. I hope y'all are developing a hatred for this world. Read, Brother Shane.
Verse 41.
Yeah, go ahead.
And thou shalt take the Levites for me, I am the master, instead of all the firstborn among the children of Israel. And the cattle of the Levites instead of all the firstlings among the cattle of the children of Israel. And Moses numbered as Yahweh commanded him, and all the firstborn among the children of Israel. And all the firstborn males by the number of names from a month old and upward.
For how old? How old?
From a
1 month old upward. Read on.
Of those that were numbered of them were 22,203.
So 22,203. That's 22,273. Firstborn males, that means there was 22,273 families in Israel. Y'all get that? All right, let's go to first chapter. Pick up on the 600,000. Y'all getting this, right? Y'all getting this, right? You see what's going on, right? For 20 years old and upward. 20 years old and upward. These are the men that is ready for war. They can go to war. Read.
Where you at in the first?
Read verse 15. Read the whole chapter if you got to. You should know where it is. And y'all too. I can't remember everything. Read on.
And of Naphtali, Ahar, the son of Izzah. These were the renowned of the congregation of the tribes of their fathers, heads of the thousands.
Where's the Bible at?
And Moses and Aaron took these men, which are expressed by their names. And they assembled the congregation together on the first day of the second month, and they declared their pedigrees after their families by the houses of their fathers according to the numbers of the names. From 20 years old and upward.
There it is. Read on.
By their posts. And as Yahweh commanded Moses, so he numbered them in the wilderness of Sinai.
Go to verse 45. You already read that, right?
No, not in the first chapter.
Yeah, read verse 44 and 45.
These are those that were numbered, which Moses and Aaron numbered, and the princes of Israel, being 12 men. Each one was for the house of his fathers. So were all those that were numbered of the children of Israel by the house of their fathers from 20 years old and upward.
How old?
20 years old.
20 years old and upward, read.
All that were able to go forth.
All that were able to go forth to war.
In Israel.
In Israel. You hear that? That's not including the ones that are 20 years old and younger, and the older people, the older men has already gotten old and they can't go to war anymore. Men that are able to go to war. And look what it says. Read on.
Even all they that were numbered were 600,000 and 3,550.
Y'all get that? So think about this for a second. Let's just use 22,000, 600,000. You take 22,000, you divide it into 600,000, you get the round figure number 77, 27. That's just males. That's just males. That's not including females. That means each family in Israel had bare minimum 27 males. More likely, each family had like 54 something children. Now you see the reason why the Egyptian wanted the males to be killed? They multiplying like rabbits. What was the fear? The fear is they keep on going like this, they're going to overtake us. What do you think America went out there many, many years ago and then bought out tanks and everything with the Mormons out there in Utah? Not that they were concerned about that, they were concerned them overtaking the federal government. Y'all remember years ago I said, don't worry about Lafayette, we can't get you out, we'll breed you out. Starting to make sense? All we got to do is move another 75 families here, and we done took over the whole township. And they are scared to death of that. You know the first thing we'll do? We'll shut down every business on the Sabbath. See, they already know. They already know, and they have dealt with us wisely. we do this thing right long enough, quick enough, fast enough, before the Father comes, we can actually buy enough land and create our own township. At least you'll know the whereabouts of your children. At least you know they won't be at the skating rink shaking their thing. Or the movies doing everything they think they're big enough to do. At least you know where they'll be at on the feast days. Look at it. What's wrong with this? But we don't want this. And we say we love our children. We say we love our children. I don't believe you love them. Not unless you are moving forward to this, because this is, remember, the restoration of all things is at hand. The kingdom of heaven is coming. And he's going to have his remnant. And the remnant are always these set apart ones. He got to set us apart so he can have them virgins that are unspotted by the world. And we're worried about our emotions and feelings. We can't even make sense of them. It's an affront to Yah himself. Let us stand. We don't want to make sure you get that spirit coming in. That's a good word. Hallelujah. Did y'all learn anything about Exodus 21? We'll keep going in this vein for a little while. Good seeing y'all face. Hallelujah. It's good seeing them Israelites, boy. It really was. Remember, man. All right, don't worry about it. Like I said, I ain't going to talk about this too much longer. A lion don't concern himself with fleas. Especially obese fleas at that. Hallelujah. It's just man talk, man. Don't get all uptight. Peace, man. Y'all's good. Y'all, we bless your magnificent name. We thank you for this holy Shabbat, your words of truth, the law, the instructions that you placed in us and given us an opportunity to actually meet your conditions before you come. Father, we pray for all of Israel that their understanding be open and that more than anything they will repent of the condition of iniquity, the sin that is within their hearts, and bring forth fruit that is meet for repentance so we can get about this restoration process of loving you and then going on into the kingdom to rule this world. We thank you for the blood and our names are written down. We thank you for everything, Father, because you've been mindful of us. I pray for more strength to continue to keep speaking your truth in the face of adversity and to continue to keep going against wind and tide for your name. We bless you for all things. In the magnificent name of Yahshua, Shabbat Shalom, the King is coming. Glory to the King.
Look at him looking.